Hello friends, today we are learning 6th standard maths whole numbers. So already we learned so many numbers, today we are seeing one new number, that is whole number. So before going to the whole number, we will go to first natural number and we will see what is a natural number. Afterwards we will go to the whole number. So first natural number I am writing here, natural numbers. Now what are the natural number? The counting numbers are called the natural number. Now which are the counting numbers? The numbers which start from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. are called natural number. So in simply you can say counting numbers are called natural numbers. This is the definition of natural number. So you can write also the number which start from the next one. You can write the numbers start from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. are what? Natural. So this is what? A natural. So we will come to our point now, that is whole number. Now, what is the whole number? First, we will see the definition of whole number. Whole numbers. If we add 0 to natural numbers, that numbers are called whole numbers. So the definition of whole number, if we add 0 to natural number, that numbers are called whole number. So this is the definition. Why we require a definition? To better understand what is natural number and what is whole number. Natural numbers start from 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. are called natural number, and whole numbers that start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. are called the whole number. Why 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc.? Because in natural number we add 0. So when you add 0 to natural number, that number became whole number. So this is definition. Now why it is required to learn whole numbers? Why not sufficient the natural number only? Why we require whole number? Because if without whole number, we cannot find the addition and subtraction, multiplication and division of some problems. Why? Because if I given here 1, 1 is a natural number. If I add 0 to 1, the answer is 1. If you don't know what is this 0, so for that purpose we are learning the whole numbers, because the 0 is in a whole number. So when you add natural number to whole number, natural number to whole number. So what is the whole number? Whole number is 0. So to come to know what is 0 and where it will become, the 0 will become in whole number. Now further we will learn more numbers. Integers we will learn. In integers what we will see? We will see the minus numbers, 0 and the plus number. That we will learn afterwards. That is not today's topic. So just I given a one clue, one point. There are so many types of number. Even number, odd number also you learn. What is even number and what is odd number you know very well. That is also we are learning in this chapter afterwards. But more focus on the today topic is whole number. Whole number. So this is definition of natural number. This is definition of whole number. Once again, what is natural number? The counting numbers are called the natural number. So always we start the counting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We never count from the 0. So if you tell to count the numbers, so you started counting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In this way you will count. So for that purpose we will be using a natural numbers. And so where will the 0 will be come? When you do same number minus, the answer is coming 0. So the 0 is important for us. For that purpose we are learning the whole number. So whole number definition. What is the whole number definition? If you add 0 to the natural number, so the numbers are called the whole number. So whole number started from where? So the whole number starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, dot dot dot, etc. Dot dot means infinity. They are infinity numbers. This is natural and old. Now today, one more point we are taking. Today, we are taking two points. One is tradition. Successor. Now, in old number, we are seeing predecessor and successor. Predecessor means before number. In short, you can say before number, as we learn in a smaller classes, lower classes, like first standard, second standard, third standard. Now, successor. Successor means what? After. In short, you can say successor means after. This is also we learn in smaller classes, lower classes, in first, second, third standard. They will ask you write after numbers and they will ask you write before number. Now, if this is a higher classes, sixth standard, we will not say that write before number and after number. So, what words we will use? We will use the predecessor and the successor. Now, here comes. Suppose I given you 9. So, what is the predecessor of this 9? So, you have to subtract 1 from given number. When predecessor is asked to you, before number asked to you, so you have to subtract 1 from given number. 9 is given. So, what is the predecessor of 9? If I minus 1 from 9, so the answer is what? 8. So, 8 is the predecessor of this 9. And what is the successor of 9? If you add 1 to the given number, so you will get the successor. So, 10 is the successor of 9. In this way, you can subtract and add to find the predecessor and successor. It means before number and after number. So, every number has a predecessor and successor. If I ask you, what is the predecessor of 1? What is the predecessor of 1? So, according to this, before number is predecessor. So, I have given you one clue. How to find the predecessor? We have to minus 1 from given number. Given number is 1. So, you have to minus 1. So, 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. So, 0 is a predecessor of 1. So, here the whole number is helping us to find the predecessor of 1. Predecessor of 1. And what is the successor of 1? Simply, you have to add 1 for the successor. So, 2. So, 2 is a successor of 1. So, here the 0 is helping us. So, what is the 0? The 0 will comes under the old number. So, this is called predecessor and successor. Now, we will take some example with a greater number. We will take some example of greater number 99. What is the successor of 99? If you add 1 to 99, the answer is what? 100. So, 100 is a successor. So, what is predecessor of 99? So, 98 is the predecessor. If you subtract 1 from the given number, 98. In this way, you can take so many examples and solve at home. So, this is called predecessor before number and this is called successor after number. Now, come to the point. One more. Natural number, you know. The natural numbers are, this is natural number. Start from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. And whole number. Now, whole number start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. If you see, this is natural number and this is whole number. So, we can say natural number to whole number. We can say this also whole number because these numbers are present in the whole number. So, you can say these numbers are whole numbers. You can say natural numbers to whole number. But you cannot say whole number to natural number. If you say these are the natural numbers, so it is false. It is wrong. Why it is wrong? Because in natural number there is no zero. So, we cannot say this is a natural number. But we can say this is a whole number. So, natural numbers are called natural number also and whole number also. But whole numbers cannot say natural number. Whole numbers are whole numbers. So, today's our topic is natural number and whole number. We've seen successor and predecessor. Successor means after. after number, predecessor means before number. Now successor means after number, predecessor means before number. So today I am giving you few some homework to you. You solve some problems which are given in the NCERT textbook. Find out the exercise. In exercise there is given write two consecutive successor of given number. So how you solve that? Write two consecutive successor of the given number. So consecutive means continuous numbers. Consecutive means continuous number 99. After you have to write two more consecutive numbers. So what is the successor of the two consecutive? One is 100 and second one is 101. And two consecutive predecessor of the given number. Suppose they given here 100. So you have to write the predecessor of this given number. So what are the predecessor? One is 99 and second one is 98. So in this way, in the exercise there are given so many numbers. Please practice at home. Tomorrow again we will meet and we will go on a new topic. Thank you.